Namaste. Welcome to shailaji.com. Today we will be starting with our letters. So let us get into the class. Already you know we have done 25 letters till now. In my previous videos you would have seen we have done 25 letters. Today we will be doing the next set of letters. These all will be 4 per row. So 12 letters we will be learning, 4 per row. So ya, ra, la, va. See how I am saying ya, yamuna, ya, ra, ra, okay, ra. Like how you say Ramesh, Ramesh, la, la, va, va. You see how I am saying va. It is not va, va. It is va, va. Okay, va. Now let me start showing you how to write it. Now you just have to take it this way, go like this, go back and bring it down. This is ya. Now already you would have learned ka, all that, no? Same way, like two you have to put, just two, that's all. This is ra, very simple. This one you have to put like the three which is in this ulta kind, okay, and then you put one stroke here. It is la. Now here you have to put, go like this. You learned ba. Same way you have to put ba. In ba you had a cut in the round, but here you don't have, that is va. See how simple it is. You just have to take it this way, go this way and go down, up and come like this. So this is ya, then ra, then la. I told you just the three, you put it in this manner and then you bring one line next to it, a vertical line, and then it becomes la. And for va, just one stroke. Yes, you can also put a vertical line and put a round here. So that also is va. But to make your writing fast, you should always go with one stroke writing. You should not go like one stroke, then two stroke. No. Instead, go with single stroke writing. If you practice like that, your writing speed will increase. Otherwise, you will be very slow in writing. This also can be written like this. You put a vertical line and then you can bring like this. This also you can write. This way too you can write, but still it will take time for you to write. That is the reason we teach you the easiest method. That's it. One stroke. All are in one stroke writing. So I think you have understood now. Ya, ra, la, va. Now let us start with the next row. Now as soon as you see this, you will be wondering, what is this? There are two sha here. So it might be quite tough. No, not at all. You just listen to my pronunciation, how I will be doing that, and I'll make it very simple for you how to remember it and how to differentiate it. So you just see that and you will feel later how simple this pronunciation and what is the difference between these two. Now the first one is sha. Okay, when I'm saying the sha, I'll tell you where you have to keep the position so that you will remember it. When you say, for example, you take some words like Shankar, Shankar, Shiv. When you are saying that, you just think in your mind, Shankar, Shiv. So when I am telling that, Sh, that means the tongue is touching just before the teeth, like how you pronounce the Ch, no? Like same way, Sh, Sh. So the tongue goes flat in before the teeth, Sh. That is where this position should come. It is Sh. If you are not able to understand, you tell the word Shankar, Shankar, Shiv, Shiv. You say that and see, you could see the tongue where the position is coming before the teeth. So upper part. So that there only this has to be pronounced. Now coming to this one. This one, you have to take your, roll your tongue and touch it on top. Sh. Automatically like a whistle sound you will get. You just try it like how you pronounce the T, T, D, D, N. When you pronounce that row, you took the tongue in a rolling position and the tip of it was touching on the top the same way. Even another letter will be pronounced the same way, that is R, A, R, there, remember the vowels which you learned. In that also you have a letter re after u matra, you have re. That also, that re also, how you pronounce re, re. Same way here also you will pronounce sh. So immediately the tongue should go up, sh. Automatically that whistle sound will come. So simple, sh, sh, sh. This is sir. Now this sir, you might think, okay, the teeth has joined together and I'm saying sir. No, inside my tongue has gone down, lower teeth, no, the there it is going like that, it will hit there down. Sir, sir, you should keep your tongue pushed to the lower teeth and you have to say sir, sir. Okay, that is the pronunciation of sir. But the teeth might show closed. The teeth both will be together. That is not the point. The tongue is touching the lower area of your teeth and saying like sir. Okay? And this is, you would have heard in so many places. See here, everywhere you have it. It is her. Okay? So it is her. Many places, like even if you want to say aap kaun hai, hai. All those areas you will be pronouncing. So this letter you should know how to pronounce. It is her, her. So the air is coming out and you are saying her. Now I think you have understood. Sh, sh, sa, ha. I think the pronunciation is very simple. Don't you think so? Right. Now let me write and show to you how to write these letters. Now you had written just the previous row, you had written ra. But slight difference, you have written R like this, am I right? Now you put a curve here and then a vertical line, it becomes SH. So many letters are similar to each other. So it becomes easy for you to write and practice also. So now this is SH. I think you remember where I've asked you to keep the, put the tongue and pronounce it. So it is SH. Think of Shankar. Now the next one. Now when you're coming here, again I told you, how you have to pronounce sh. Now so simple, you have written already this kind of a letter in the 25 letters pa, am I right? So you just take it like a u. Okay, so you just take it like a u and bring a vertical stroke here just like pa, but then you have a cross cut. Remember the cut should be only from this end to this end and you, then you put a stroke. How simple it is. See, now the next one, again, like how you put the ra, you put the ra, no, same way. You put it, a cut here, and then a vertical line. It becomes sa. Now her, you might be thinking, what is this? It's going twisting and turning and how difficult it looks. No, you just see here, just put a small vertical line, go like this, it will come like this. See, like a parrot hook, no, like that it is, the beak. Just bring it like that and go back and bring it. Simple. Now, you want to try another way. Just put this, put it, stop there and do this. That way also you can try. Very simple, one stroke. Yes. Simple, one stroke. The small vertical line thing, go back and come here. See how easy you have practiced. Sha, sha. Sa, ha. So you've understood this row also. Now let us go to the final row, the last four letters. You might be seeing this and you wondering, so complicated it is to write, it looks so complicated. Never mind, I'll make it very simple for you. Now the first one we pronounced as ksha, ksha, k-s-h-a, ksha. I have given here also something written underneath. Now, these letters are compound letters. That means made out of two individual consonants. With that, these letters have been made. So, now how it has been made? This, I told you in the first video of consonants, I told you when the stroke comes like this, it is half sound. It is half sound. So, the letter doesn't have any vowel in it. So, it is half ik. So, ik plus sh, the previous row we studied, sh. So ik plus sh, sh, it is ksh, ksh. Okay, kaksha, Akshay, Kshatriya, Kshatriya. So those kind of words you will use. For all that you use this letter. Now the next one is Tra, Tra, Tra. So you know already the third row how you should pronounce with a tongue in between the teeth. So it plus Ra, Tra. It plus Ra, Tra. The next one is little confusing only. This is Ij. Okay, J. That is in Ch row, third consonant. Ij. Ij plus Nya in the same row end. It is Ij plus Nya. It becomes Gya. G-Y-A. Gya. It is not Nya. It is Gya. G-Y-A. The next one is Shra. S-H-R-A. Shra, Shra. It is Shravan, Shravan. You say no like that. Shravan. So this is Ish plus Ra. It is Shra. That is Shravan, Shravan. Okay, now you've got these letters. Now, if you see here, all these letters are used in Sanskrit, and all the words which we have taken from Sanskrit have these kind of letters. Now, if you see here, you have Kaksha, you have Vaksh, you have Raksh, Vriksh. So many words you have, which all are Sanskrit words. Here, Trinetra, Tribhuvan, Trimas. All that there are some words like Trimas means 3 months. So like that you have words which will come in this also. Gyan, Vigyan, Yajna, all that it is used. Here, Shravan, Shram, Shramik. There are words like that which come from Sanskrit and we have taken. Now, actually the sound, this one, if you see, I've given here Ij, but the sound will be like this. Ig plus Nya, Gya. It sounds that way, but it is not this variation. It is only this. Then we should have pronounced as Gya, Gya. No, but we cannot do that. We are doing it in this manner only. We are doing it as Gya. We are not giving this Gya, Gya. That Nya and Ij sound we are not giving. We are giving it only with G sound, Gya. Okay? So, Ksha, Tra, Gya, Shra. Now, let me take you to writing of these letters. Now, if you see this, first you can go like this, take it this way, then you come like this, then this way, and then you put a vertical line. Yes, you are done. This is Ksha. Now, Tra is very simple. You learnt Re in your vowels. Same way you do it. In Re, you bring another this side, a three kind of thing, a cursive three, but that not required here. You just stop with this, and this is Tra. Now, here if you see, you have to just, yes. Okay, this is Gya. And this one, and this line, and this. Remember, this and this, you see the parallel, how it is coming? It should come this way, then only the stroke will be correct. You see here, how I have brought it? So you have to bring like this and bring it this way. So these two are going parallel. These two lines are going parallel. That way you have to write it. Now this also I'll show you. You go like this, first stroke, then you bring it like this. Like two. You first bring one stroke, bring a two down, put one line and this. It's done. Now, Ksha, Tra, Gya, Shra. So we have completed all the letters. Now I'm going to show you another two letters. You might be wondering, she already told me 39 letters. Now where from these two letters have come? In many books you find these two letters also mentioned in the Varnamala, that is in the consonants in Vyanjan. Now these letters are from the Urdu letters. So this is Z, Z, and this is F, F. Okay, this is F and this is Z. Now remember this, when you use this, generally you will have, you might say Jamindar, J-A you might pronounce. No, this is Zamindar, Z. in books, English books, if you have seen, the Z letter would be added. So it will be Zamindar, and this is Fa. Okay? Farsh, Fakir. All, there are so many words in Fa letters. When there is a dot only, you have to pronounce it. Now, for example, I'll tell you. Now, you would have already learned this in your consonants. In the second row, this is J. This is J, this is P. Now this is Phal, all that it has come. Now this is Fana. You would have heard the movie Fana. So that F, and this is Zameen, Zameen. So that kind of, that word all, when the, that sound, Awaz, Awaz, Z. So that sound will be given for these letters. So I have also added this for you, for your information. So we have completed all our letters. I think you would have understood all the consonants. I think I've done it in 3 to 4 videos. You will be able to understand everything if you go through all my videos from the beginning. And if you have any doubts, please mention it in the comment box below. Please like, share and subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will get my new videos notification. Thank you for watching my videos, and please watch it till the end. Only then you'll be able to understand how easy it is to learn Hindi. Thank you so much for supporting me, and Namaste.